Well, I am Alicia Lopez Medina. I work in University UNED, which is a national distance education university in Spain. And I am the head of a unit which is called Technology Innovation. And in my unit, I am responsible for the repository, institutional repository. This is good news because that means that in my university, repositories are related to innovation, which means that things are changing in the way things are happening in the university, research, education, and there is a need of a new system to support processes, information processes in the university. So I'm a librarian, a repository manager, and I am the executive director of COAR, the Confederation of Open Access Repositories. And today I am here representing COAR, and I am going to talk about these challenges for open access repositories from an international perspective, from the effort we are doing in COAR to create support these new needs of management of information. So I'm going to start. How do I move this here? So I would like to start by, do you hear me?
It's better if you use this.
Why? Okay. It's better. No, look, and there is this sound. Okay. So we are talking about data, but I would like to framework this need of data in what has changed in research. In research. I think it doesn't work. So do you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, so data are important, but the thing is internet, and this is obvious, and we say this all the time, has made a revolutionary opportunity for many things, especially in our case for research. So research is intensive use of data, of course, but it's also, as he said, global, and it's a collaborative, computationally intensive. That means that research is doing by machines, analyzing and processing all the information. And it's also virtual. This collaboration is virtual. It's done online through global collaboratives. So this is an important stress for us responsible for supporting this research in terms of information management. So this means that there is another way we have to create the objects that are a result of this kind of research. We have to find another way of providing access of information, providing support for reusing, etc. So the opportunity is this open science we are talking about today, which means that this collaborative and computational intensive and global and virtual collaborative are open. So means they can share. They might share tools, results, and everything, publications, data, software. You mentioned also the question of software. So one thing then that you can see here, and it has been mentioned already, for research, it's not only data. I will talk about that later. So the idea I wanted to get in this open science concept is that the objective of open research, to be open, is to make it more efficient, more transparent, more trustworthy. So the opportunity is for scientists now is that they can do things that before they were not able to do it, or it would have taken 100 years to do it, right? So it has to be using the opportunity of new technologies and internet. So I would like to propose you a broader understanding of open access and the driver of what is driving open access. it's also, yes, the journals are very expensive and we have to look for a business model and stuff, but for a broader perspective, open access is moved because e-research and the requirement of e-research need open access, so the full exploitation of internet. And I will talk also about this open access intelligent. I liked that very much, the intelligence of openness. So repositories, I would like to frame repositories, open access repositories in this broader picture, not only in gold or green or publication only, but in the whole picture of research. The whole matter of needs or the whole cycle of research. And I believe that repositories, those systems that manage digital information, we can make a change. Because so far I feel like we are talking very much in a transition period, but we are very much stuck in the print area. We haven't gone, well, many researchers did, but to the native digital world, where things are happening in a different way, and concepts are also changing. So I think we can change the way research is done, not change maybe, but support the change in research by exposing rich knowledge-oriented information assets. Because remember that repositories are systems to manage, to do things with digital objects. So this is a very naive, but I think graphic, of research cycle. I took it from Leo Weicher. I don't know if you know him. Many years ago, he came to Madrid and he showed this, and I think it's a very nice expression of what is happening here. You see, this collaboration, this global and virtual community, what we have there is a bunch of data. Data for me, I only from the repository manager's perspective, I would like to broaden also the concept of data. Not only data as understood by your presentation, but data as models, publications, say even simulations, versions, you know, and they have to use those global data integrated as a one object, because they have to be linked, otherwise they don't have meaning, and they have to use them in offering tools in private or shared environments and collaborative workspaces, which means that before publication, there is a work. So not only happens when something is published, the story begins before that, and a lot of things are happening before the final publication is actually published. And repository, we have to follow the whole workflow of research. And here we can have open access to intermediate publications. This is final enhanced and draft enhanced publication, which means in this new research, what is a publication? It's not anymore an article. It's a complex object made out of all these pieces that the data, what they wrote, the graphics, the simulation, the software they use. All of this is, as you said, and I agree, completely dynamic. They annotate, they comment, they change, they process, they reuse. So this is an opportunity for repositories, data repositories, publication repositories, to support these complex objects and new models of use those objects. So the Berlin Declaration in 2003, they told us already how to do that. So we have internet and the technologies to make the global and interactive representation of human knowledge. And to do that, we need content and software. They must be freely accessible and interoperable. So for me and for the point of view repositories, which are the responsible to take care of these objects, for the researchers to use them, this is what we have to do. Not only open repositories, the data set repositories, web resources, all of these repositories that are responsible for managing objects. What we have to do is to make them open access intelligent to the machines. So what means for me intelligent means that they are linked. That means they are related in a way that structured in a way that the internal structure is machine readable, so we can make this link between the data, the publication. Even we can go further, as he said in linked data. Data is also the name of the researcher, and we are working in an author ID, persistent identificator, and there is also the possibility for us to go the object with the rights of use that object, or the provenance, or the versions, or the comments, or the different metadata to use in different systems. So this is the representation of what the Internet in Berlin Declaration, they said, is the global virtual representation of knowledge. The key point is that every piece of the knowledge has to be linked, has to be linked. So this is where we have really a job to do, open access repositories. First, we have to have the content open for human, of course, with these policies that we were listening this morning. But then we have to do to open these to the machines, because the power of the new research is because agents and software and intelligent robots are going to use these intelligent objects we are preparing and structuring in our repositories to do marvelous things that can challenge, you know, this climate, weather. And I put this example because it looks like e-research is only for science, but e-research is also for humanities and social science. So this is an example only of how different sources of data can be structured in a way that the machines are going to ask this. We are going to be able to ask this question. He said, I don't remember the question, but it was a very intelligent question, and the machine can understand that and answer. So because underneath we are there, the repository is managing this object in a very intelligent way. Semantic web, actually, I'm talking about. So, to realize this potential, to create this global knowledge object, to use and reuse, a key issue is interoperability. This is an interoperability workshop. And we need also, and it has been mentioned here, a community. We need to collaborate closely together, repositories, to feel like we are a community. And as we are only one part of the wider infrastructure, we also need to engage with the other parts of this e-research infrastructure. So this is why we have created the Confederation of Open Access Repositories, which is an international non-profit association. You see, we are already 100 institutions, and we are represented in many on the continents of the world. And we have created it because we need a community. We have to create a repository community in order to lead and to advance in creating this network. So we have here not only this new institute, I mention it because we have many represented here from Turkey that are becoming members of COAR. It's Ms. Gultekin, it's around here. There, Gultekin. But we have future members from Turkey, lately. So what we want to do as a community, we want to create this infrastructure of repository, open access infrastructure, to facilitate that a better visibility of research results, but also a greater application. That means to make this, facilitate researchers to do better things and more things with these objects. and we based it on interoperability and international cooperation. So now, what? How many times do I have left? 10. So the first focus we have as an organization, of course, as open access organization. Nothing is possible if we don't have objects in the repository. It has been said today, you know. Repositories without content, all these marvelous plans of the semantic global representation, we cannot do it because we don't have the object. So one of our focus in CoAR is to give ideas to the international community about how to increase the deposit of objects in our in the repository. So we have a report that is coming up soon. The chair of this report is Catherine Shear, and she's from the Canadian Association of Research Libraries. And this is some of them that has been already mentioned. Strategies to improve the deposit on the deposit in the repositories. And this is in international. So what we have is we have gathered all the experiences in different parts of the world. Japanese are very good in that. They have a wonderful program. I don't have time to show you, but it's very effective. And then there is, CoAR is promoting and supporting, this is called Open Access Agreement and License Task Force. So this is a multi-organization initiative. I will show you later the members. And the idea is like we as library, well, some people here are librarian, right? So we make agreements in consortia or national or just institutional when we buy, when we subscribe the journals and databases, and we sign agreements and clauses in those agreements. So this Open Access License Task Force wants to look for new models and innovative ways of including in those agreements open access clauses. Like, for instance, the condition in that license that when we subscribe these journals, that our authors in our institution, they are allowed to put the articles in the repositories without paying any extra. So I will show you who is participating in this. As you see, there are CoAR members, but there are people not from CoAR. So this is an independent task force, which is supported by CoAR. You see, for instance, the Maxdan Digital Library, Neil from JISC, which is over there. It's also JISC is a member of this task force, and the World Bank publication. So we support also the community because as being international, there are different levels of development in repositories. We have this initiative. Irina Kuchma is the chair of this working group, which is dedicated to training and to help and support. We have taken ideas from OpenAIRE, like with the help desk a little bit and the national portal. We have online workshop. Lately, the last one, Eloy was giving an interoperability webinar. And also we provide training materials from all over the world. So it's international. International outreach. Very quickly, I wanted to show you that we are in as many places as we can in the world. So we have been doing workshops. Oh, how do I go? It's because I don't have my glasses. Yeah, thank you very much. So we've been in like in Berlin 10 in a workshop. It was Irina, it was Eloy, who else was from here? Well, they were in Berlin 10. We were also in the Open Repository Conference, another workshop about interoperability. We were in Cuba. Cuba is doing great things now, developing in the Caribbean and regional network. We have been twice, 2 years in Cuba, giving them advice, support, training, and now they are starting really with the repository network. We were also in Bangalore, in India, and in Colombia, and China. You see, we are really developing a very international action. We create community also with our annual meeting. Next year will be, now it's going to be in Istanbul. And at the beginning, this annual meeting was only a general assembly, but now it's becoming also a conference. We have called for papers, and we are going to organize tutorials. Jochen, which is over there, is going to talk about the new metrics for data usage in repositories. Okay, Irina is organizing these tutorials. Then a newsletter I go. The support for regions. This is very important initiative that in the region of Latin America, and we have really been an important support for them. And then this is private because it has been released today. We are offering a repository observatory because we want to keep. This is a very evolving situation. Repositories are changing. Everything is changing so quickly that to make the decisions, you need to have a little strategic vision. So we would like to provide repository community with this strategic vision, a little bit of scanning the horizon and see what is coming up and what could be the best option for them and the direction. So it's, for this one, we have interviewed Michelle Kimpton. I suppose you all know Michelle Kimpton. She is from Dura Space, and she is talking about what is going to happen new in this space and Fedora for the next years. What are the strategic direction? And I think this is important for us because we are this space and Fedora users. And there is also profiles, briefing about new projects, new initiatives that are interesting to offer new perspectives of what repositories could offer. So I invite you to take a look at the new repository observatory. So interoperability, which is the subject today, actually. So this is one of the main actions of CoAR, because everything actually, if you want to create infrastructure, you need to base it in interoperability. So it's in our strategic direction. It has been always an important focus. The main results to now is this current state of open access repository interoperability. I don't know if you had the chance to read it. And it has been led by Eloy. And it presents an overview, actually, of this is the first part, in general. So the idea is to have this area of possible services and what kind of initiatives and protocols you can use if you are a repository manager and you have to take decisions. So as you see, we go from the very simple OAMPMH, which could look to you very obvious, but there are countries in the world that they don't know exactly what is that, and they are is now doing these portals and they're harvesting, and they need to know also this. And we go down to this OAIRE, which is the frontier towards the semantic web, which will come this new, more sophisticated and complex objects in the next part of the report. Eloy? And this is a nice picture, isn't it? We signed a memorandum of understanding last, Pablo?
November,
yeah. So this is very important because, as I said, we are only part of the infrastructure for research. And there's this investigation databases that we have in our universities and research institutions. They give the contextual also information about our repository documents. So, I think this is going to be a very good partnership. We will talk late tomorrow about how we organize the collaboration, but I think it's a very good news that the two communities get together, and we have a and we can offer the first of all a seamless workflow for our researchers. They are very bored when they have to push buttons and upload things, and if we make it easier and we say, don't worry, you only have to go here and push a button and the rest, don't worry, we will do it for you. So that would be very good. And then we also want to engage with the data community. So we plan to go to Gothenburg and for the Research Data Alliance launch and first plenary. And we might participate in a working group. We have to discuss that yet. But this one, you know, data publications linking. So I believe everything is about linking in this world. So we are going. Yes, you today I'm talking about the semantic. So it's we will be there and we will discuss if time. So I'm finishing because I wanted to show you all the partnership we are open in core with different parts of the infrastructure. Libre, it's also important, as I told you, I'm in the library and I am a repository manager, so I'm a librarian and a repository manager at the same time. And this memorandum is really giving us, the librarians, a new role in as a profession in the university, and I think it's also important for Libre having an international dimension, and I go there, and this is from Eloy. I finish. So I invite you to become an active in the global core community, and thank you very much for listening. Oh, here are my glasses.
Any question for?